If you're a Google Workspace administrator, setting up DMARC, SPF, and DKIM is one of the most important steps you can take to protect your emails. In this video, I'll be showing you exactly how to set up email authentication for your Gmail business domain and why it's crucial. DMARC helps prevent hackers from impersonating your domain, stopping phishing attacks and email spoofing before they even reach your inbox. By setting it up, you're not only protecting your own emails, but also building trust with anyone who receives messages from your domain. To configure SPF for Google Workspace, it is a very simple process. All you would have to do is include this include statement into your existing SPF record, or in the case where you do not have an SPF record yet, you can copy in this full statement as a TXC record on your DNS. And once that is done and the record has propagated, all your emails coming out of Google Workspace will be SPF passing. So let's go ahead and add this record to our DNS. On my DNS here, I already have an existing SPF record. So rather than adding in the full statement, I will only have to add in the include. So I'll go ahead and paste that in. Once I verify that the syntax is correct and all is well, and that I copied in the correct include statement, which is in this case the Google one, I will go ahead and save my record so that it updates, and all my emails will then be DMARC capable. To generate Google DKIM, you would have to head over to your Google admin panel. On the admin panel, on the left-hand side, if you navigate under Apps, Google Workspace, and into the Gmail tab, assuming your domain is already verified, you'll be able to reach this page once you go to the Authenticate Email tab. On this tab, you'll be able to select your domain and see the current status. So currently, my emails are not DKIM signed. So I can press the generate new record button here, select my DKIM key bit length. Here, 2048 keys are recommended. However, if your DNS does not support this, you can go ahead with 1024. So I'll go ahead and put this as 2048. In terms of the prefix selector, the default and recommended value to have is Google. However, you can edit this, but as I mentioned, it is recommended to do Google. Clicking the generate button here will then update the authentication settings so that it will generate a new DKIM record for me. So I'll go ahead and refresh this page to show you this DKIM record. Once the page is refreshed, I'm able to see my DNS hostname being google.underscore domain key, as well as my record value. Now I'll have to go back to the DNS and publish this DKIM selector. Once that's done, I will start the authentication, which may take some time as it takes into account the DNS propagation as well as the authentication time as well. So I'll go ahead and do that now. Now that I've pasted in the values into my DNS, I will save this record so that I can start the propagation and eventually the authentication process. To configure DMARC for your domain as a Google Workspace admin, you can follow this documentation here. Taking this example DMARC record, I can see that I would have to have the following tags. However, I'll be updating the RUA and RUF tags to be targeting to PowerDMARC. So go ahead and copy this, make the changes, and show them to you on the DNS. For your information, you can view all the tags and definitions here as to what tag represents what in a DMARC record, and you can refer to our in-depth DMARC record video for more information. So go ahead on the DNS and make the changes. On the DNS, I have went ahead and created a new TXC record, the name being underscore DMARC, with the following content, taking it from the example shared from the Google Workspace help page. Once that's done, I can save this record and I will have configured DMARC through Google Workspace for my DNS. Once I'm done with my source alignment, I can then upgrade this policy to reject to fully protect my domain against spoofing. And that's it. You've successfully set up the email authentication protocols for your Google Workspace domain. By doing this, you've taken a huge step in protecting your domain and emails from being misused by cybercriminals. Now, your Gmail domain is better equipped to prevent phishing attacks and email spoofing, giving you and your recipients more peace of mind. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more guides on email security and authentication. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.